break today. I'm doing a bit of anti-roll and we saw sharpening and more hewing
saw sharpening.
Dat warm is 40 tot 50 graden.
Is dat een avaar?
Ja.
Essen, ja.
And then the line.
You can get the perfect angle with this.
What do you mean?
This. If you want to hit all the way meet, it will all the way through.
And you want to make.
So you don't have this.
Oh, yeah.
Here.
Yeah.
I went all the way here. And out. When I do this race, there'll be absolutely no stops.
Yeah, yeah.
So water won't stay in it, so it won't drop. Uh-huh. And so at the end, you get like a perfect clean surface.
Okay, that technique, what I've seen, has disappeared during the, like, you see 13th century, 14th century, 15th century, 16th still, and when you get to the 17th,
you forgot.
No, I think they're using more one-sided, one beveled accent, so you get that more like red bar style finish,
which is more like with this style of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Between those accents, you can do it, but you can also do it usually like this.
It's horrible.
It's horrible.
It's horrible, right?
Like I said, if you have only your teeth or this, well, that works very well.
Use your teeth.
But, yeah.
That stone came from exactly the same quarry as in Brittany, where they found some antique stones. So
not the most efficient tool at all.
Yeah.
right here, and you're going to use more splitting and thinning around here. You'll have some terra that will come here, and the grain won't be cut, so you'll come and here your counter fiber, and you'll split it around. So that's why I make a notch here, because that's where the fiber will have a mess. Cool. So just like come this.
The best way, the most efficient way for me to work with it is to have, if you have the choice, it would be to drill one hole at each end of the mortise. Or if it's straight on both sides, if it's like for a brace and you have your mortise like this on the side, you just drill one hole here. And once you get this, you with with the mortise and cannon side, you will just like start making a trench in the middle between your two holes of drill. You make a trench, you go to the depth you want, and you sweep it around and you just hew the inside of your mortise with the axe side. That gets all the way to the line. Using more the end of the axe usually, that is what I prefer. And you see how I attack like this to get exactly at the edge, and then I've slowly turned to get more into the line. See, I'm not hitting hard, I'm just giving like small. Oops, that one came back. Now that I'm roughly at the line, so I have to come a bit here and clean. I'll start and get up a little, get the angle. Maybe, yeah, I don't think that's gonna be nice. nice photo.
Okay.